Okay, so the ingredients we're going to be needing is some chicken breasts, pounded and floured. I'm using 4 chicken breasts today. Salt and pepper. This is lemon juice, white wine, olive oil, chicken stock, some capers, some fresh parsley or basil, some garlic, some butter, some onion, some spaghetti, and that's basically it. I'm gonna put all the measurements below in the description box. Okay, let's get started. Okay, so the first thing I'm gonna do is just get some olive oil and butter in a pan, and you want the pan really nice and hot. So just a tablespoon of olive oil, a tablespoon of butter. I'm just gonna wait for all that to melt together. Okay, so I'm just gonna get my chicken in the pan. Chicken is floured on both sides. Okay, I'm gonna let that cook on one side for about 2 minutes and then flip it over. Okay, these are ready to flip. Looks delicious. Okay, and I'm gonna let these go on the other side for probably just about a minute to a minute and a half, and then I'm gonna remove it and I'll show you the next step. Okay, so I just removed the chicken and I removed it a little bit shy of the finishing time, and I'll show you why later. So now we have this butter and oil in the pan, and now I'm going to do something that I kind of created myself. I'm taking about 2 tablespoons of capers and I'm just going to throw it right in here. And be careful. And basically the capers are going to fry, and when they fry they're going to pop and get a little bit crispy, and I'm gonna cook it just like that, and then I'm gonna remove them and I'm gonna save that for the end, and it's just gonna be a little bit crunchy, and that's sort of my sort of different kind of take on chicken piccata. That's sort of where I add my own interesting twist. So I'm just letting this go really not a long time at all. It's good enough for me. I hope you can see that they're a little crispy, so now I'm going to remove them, put them aside. That was just about 30 seconds. And I'm going to put the flame back on, add a little bit more olive oil, and a bit more butter. And I'm going to add the onion. This is about 2 tablespoons of chopped onion. You can add more or less, it's just to your taste. Okay, and I'm just going to turn on the heat a little bit. So it's on medium, and I'm just gonna let these saute for, I don't know, about 30 seconds, and I'll see you back. Okay, and now it's time to add the garlic. This is about 3 cloves of roughly chopped garlic. And I'm just gonna let this saute for about 30 seconds as well. Okay, so that was sauteing just for about 30 seconds. And now for the fun part. Heat is on medium to medium high, and I'm adding about 1 cup of white wine. Okay, that's gonna cook off quite a bit. And I'm also going to add some chicken stock.
And I'm going to add about 1.5 cups. I know that that seems a lot, but we're creating a sauce for our pasta as well. So, you know, we want quite a lot. So now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna add some salt and pepper. I'm gonna let this cook for about 10 minutes. I want it to reduce down to about half, so I'll see you back. Okay, so the sauce is reduced down to about half. And now what I'm going to do is add the lemon juice. You want to add this sort of towards the end so the lemon juice doesn't get too bitter and sour. This is 1.5 lemons. So add that. And I'm also going to add a tablespoon of butter. And I'm just putting a little bit of flour on the butter. You could just also add the flour. This will just help thicken the sauce a little bit. I'm going to add the chicken back into the pan. And also, I didn't mention to you, the spaghetti is almost done as well. And we're adding the chicken back in, which is, and then this is why I had removed the chicken just like maybe a minute shy of being finished, because I didn't want it to get tough when it goes back in here, because it's going to cook in here for maybe like another minute or two. And the chicken is also going to help thicken the sauce, because if you remember, the chicken has some flour on it. Okay, so let the chicken get coated on both sides. It's beautiful. Okay, and I'm going to let this cook for about 2 minutes. I'll see how it thickens up, and I'll see if it needs any more flour. Okay, that looks absolutely beautiful. I would say that that's finished. You don't want the sauce to be too thick, and most of the sauce is going to go with your pasta. So the last thing I'm going to do is add some fresh parsley. I would add more, but I actually don't have any more. But I like a lot of parsley. And I'm going to add some lemons, lemon slices. So I put the capers on at the end, and you know, they don't really flavor the sauce too much. They're more of like a little extra crispy topping. And that's basically it. So we're going to serve it up with the pasta, so I'll see you back. Okay, everybody, I'm gonna give it a try, I'll let you know how it is. Try some of the pasta first. Very good. Nice and light, but extremely flavorful. Not the lemon juice isn't overpowering at all. It's really, really well balanced. It's delicious. Alright. Now for the chicken. We got a little caper, a little bit of everything on here. That's really, really good. It's similar to chicken franchise, but I really like the addition of the capers, and they're just a little bit crunchy, and they add a little bit of extra, you know, something interesting. And like I said, if you want to put grated cheese on top of the spaghetti as well, that would be really, really good. So, I hope you give my recipe a try, and until next time, bye-bye!